let us consider the cause of asthma. In these five clinical studies, it was discovered that people with asthma breathe about 2.5 times more air than the medical norm. These are details of these studies. It's important to notice that people can breathe 2-3 times more air than the medical norm and be unaware that their breathing is way too heavy. In relation to asthma, the effects of hyperventilation are going to be following. When people hyperventilate, we have low level of CO2 in the airways. And CO2, according to clinical studies, is very powerful, some studies say most powerful, known relaxant of smooth muscles. Therefore, CO2 is dilator of airways. And when people hyperventilate, they suffer from bronchoconstriction. So this is exactly the case with people with asthma. Bronchoconstriction is one of the three central factors which defines asthma. Therefore, it's obvious that heavy breathing, which was found in virtually all asthmatics, is the cause of the bronchoconstriction or constriction of airways. Hyperventilation reduces oxygen level in body cells. Let us look at this brain image. When people hyperventilate, they have low CO2, and CO2 is also a dilator of blood vessels. Therefore, hyperventilation causes vasoconstriction, constriction of blood vessels, due to reduction of CO2 in the arterial blood. Therefore, asthmatics are going to suffer from low oxygen level. If asthmatics have too heavy breathing for a long time, they start to destroy the airways and alveoli, and that causes reduction in oxygen transport in the lungs, and we develop so-called ventilation perfusion mismatch. As a result of low oxygen level, the immune system becomes suppressed, and it also becomes hypersensitive to innocent triggers. Therefore, it's normal that asthmatics, due to the hyperventilation, develop allergies and sensitivities to dust mites, cat and dog proteins found in air, smoke, and many other chemicals. Because of this hypersensitivity of the immune system, asthmatics develop inflammation of airways. This also involves production of extra mucus. As we can see, that overbreathing leads to all symptoms of asthma. And therefore, hyperventilation is the key cause of asthma. In order to prove this statement, we need to consider the effects of those breathing techniques which are able to eliminate hyperventilation.